What I wanted to talk to you about today is I've had a number of different people, they've come to me and they've said, Father, we're approaching Holy Week and I can't go to the liturgies, and so I feel really disconnected from Christ in this time. And I get that, because I can't imagine, well, I can sort of imagine, but not near as much as you guys, who you can't go to the liturgy, you can't go to the Mass. How big of a separation that would have to feel for you. But this is not new. This has happened in many different ages of the church, that we have been unable to go to the sacraments from time to time. So how can we remain united to the holy mysteries of Holy Week when we can't go to the liturgies? Well, I think there's a number of different ways to do it. One is you could actually go to these daily masses and really participate in them online in the YouTube channels that we've been providing. Two, if you're capable, I highly recommend doing the Liturgy of the Hours throughout this week, because the Liturgy of the Hours is our prayer being united with Christ's prayer. And so every day you would be walking with Jesus and praying the Liturgy of the Hours. But for most of you, those things may not be possible. And so what I want to recommend is a two-pronged approach here, and this would be the bare minimum. Pray the readings of the day, the Mass readings of the day, go through them once, maybe twice, and then just say a prayer like this prayer before the crucifix. Behold, O kind and gentle Jesus, I kneel before you and pray that you impress upon my heart the virtues of faith, hope, and charity, with true repentance for my sins and a firm purpose of amendment. At the same time, with sorrow, I meditate on your five precious wounds, having in mind the words which David spoke in prophecy, they have pierced my hands and my feet, I can count all my bones. So if you, at the very minimum throughout this week, every day, you read the readings and then prayed this prayer before the crucifix, you would really be uniting yourself to Jesus throughout this week. You'd really be staying close to the mysteries that we are moving through in this time. And of course, there's many other things that you could do. You can pray your rosary, you can do the Divine Mercy Chaplet, you can do the Stations of the Cross, and those are all excellent things. But I think if you did just these two things, you did the daily readings, and then you prayed the prayer before the crucifix every day, you would really be remaining in this grace of the moment, to stay with Jesus Christ as he approached his death. And so, dear friends, let's really strive to be united to Jesus in this week in the best way that we can. And let's trust that God is going to handle the rest. He's not going to leave us alone, even if we have to be isolated from other people and isolated from the sacraments. He's not going to leave us without his grace and power.